Hi, I'm Patrick McCarthy. I am Executive Director of the Bluhm Cardiovascular Institute, former Chief of Cardiac Surgery here at Northwestern. With me today is Kevin Hodges. Kevin came to us and brought along a robotic skill set, which he's using for mitral valve surgery and for many other operations as well. Welcome, Kevin.
Thanks, Pat. I'm extremely happy to be here, extremely happy to join the mitral valve program and to bring robotic and minimally invasive options to that program. Pat, one of the things that I was most excited about joining Northwestern was the incredible results that you've achieved over many, many years, and you just published some really important papers about that. Could you tell us about that a little bit?
Yeah, so after so many decades of doing mitral valve repair, I tried to put a lot of thoughts in place about exactly how to do it. As you know, frequently repair has been thought of as more of an art, and we're trying to make it a science. And so what we did was we started to create really a very specific algorithm or process for how you do repair. Most surgeons only do 5 a year, and it may take 100 before they get very good at it. But the way that we're teaching people now, we think that they'll be able to do this after maybe 10, 20, 30, and that they'll be able to get really good reproducible results. A lot of people talk about their 30-day or their 1-year follow-up, but we're looking at a 10-year follow-up.
Yeah, that's really exciting. Obviously, the reason people go to a place like Northwestern for their mitral valve repair surgery, it's not just the incredible short-term outcomes, the low risk of death, the low risk of complications, but the fact that that valve is going to last them hopefully 10 years or longer, hopefully the rest of their life.
So we were really happy when we looked at the results. People talk about a failure rate, meaning a reoperation or patients redevelop severe MR of 1 to 2% every year. Ours went 10 years before they get 1 to 2% failure rate. So as we tell patients, for the majority of them, it's going to last the rest of their life. So Kevin, it's a great technique. We know it's really durable. We know that the results are great in 30 days, 0.2% mortality and very little morbidity. How are you gonna adapt that and do that with a robot?
Yeah, that's a really great question and something we talk about a lot. And really the whole point of robotic mitral valve surgery is that we can reproduce the exact same operation on the inside of the patient as what you would do through a standard approach. So there's a lot that goes into that, picking the right patient so we know that we'll have really excellent short and long-term outcomes. But there's a lot of sort of technical advantages to the robot that help us to achieve that. We have fully articulating arms and instruments. We have three-dimensional high-definition optics with a 10x zoom on the robotic camera that really allows us to do the same operation that you've perfected over all these years through a smaller incision to make it less invasive for the patient.
I know that you took the team off for a lot of training. I hear that it's going seamlessly, like you're able to get caught up right as if they've been doing it every day. How'd you pull it off?
I'm fortunate to come from a program with a well-established track record in robotics, and I understand a system that is very reproducible. So to come to Northwestern, it was just a matter of training the team and really spending, you know, the weeks and the hours to do simulation and practice cases and really make sure that everybody was 100% up to speed before we even did our first case. And we've been able to take that reproducible system and bring it here. And really from the very first patient that we did a robotic operation at Northwestern, it's felt just the same as it has all.
So Kevin, we all want the best result for the patient. And so how do you decide which patients are best with robotic? What patient group may be best with a small sternotomy incision? What goes into that decision making?
Yeah, that's really important. And, you know, I think the benefit of adding something like robotics to a program like Northwestern's is that we can really offer the right approach to the right patient. So for patients who are the right candidate, don't have any risk factors for complications, a robotic approach is excellent. It has a cosmetically superior result and gets people back to their normal lives in about 2 weeks, which is really, really outstanding. But for many people, a good old fashioned median sternotomy is better because it can be safer if they have certain risk factors, and that's a tried and true approach. So we're able to offer both options, and we pick the right patients and give them the least invasive result that we can without making any compromises.
Well, we are really happy to have you here and have the robotic component to this, but you know, it's really in sort of this milieu that we have for treating patients with this. So we have MitraClip for patients with functional MR, MitraClip for patients with degenerative MR that are high risk, and now we're in a randomized trial for patients that aren't quite so high risk. We can replace the valve either surgically or transcatheter. So the world's really changed, and so now as what are considered comprehensive mitral centers these days aren't just that you do a good repair, it's that you can do it with a robotic, you can do transcatheter treatments. I can't think of a single mitral valve procedure that we don't offer.
Yeah, that's the beauty of a place like Northwestern for mitral valve surgery. We have not just multiple expert mitral valve surgeons who can do robotics, they can do traditional approaches, but we have access right here to world-class transcatheter therapies and everything you can think of to make sure you get the very best result.